Yo guys, Dr. No was a huge success at the box office back in 1962. So obviously, the filmmakers decided to adapt another James Bond book, which came out in 1963, called From Russia with Love. Let's talk about it. I might discuss a few plot points for the movie From Russia With Love, so if you don't want anything to get spoiled, watch the movie first and then come back to this video. That said, let's start with the negatives. Most of the negatives that I had for Dr. No can also be said for this movie, and that is that there are some dated special effects. It doesn't have as much action as you might expect from a Bond movie. And doesn't have all the cool spy gadgets yet. And in the hotel room, you have this dated moment where Bond is just tipping the doorman and looking for bugs in his room. But the James Bond theme is playing like it's a huge action scene. Maybe he was just checking where the music was coming from. And those, again, are all the negatives I could think of for this movie. From there, we can luckily go to the positives. Most people, me included, think that this movie even improves on Dr. No. It is even Sean Connery's personal favorite Bond movie. I can say that pretty much everything Dr. No did well were done even better in this movie. In my Dr. No review, I said that some of the music was pretty dated. In this movie, all of the music is good. And in this movie, we also have more elements that most people associate with the James Bond movies. Here you get some gadgets, even though we only have a booby-trapped briefcase, which was still a very cool gadget. And we have the iconic opening sequence, which will be used in all the Bond films following. And now I'm actually reading the book From Russia With Love. And the movie also follows the story of the book very closely. The motivation of the bad guys is very similar, but I won't go too far in discussing the differences between the book and the movie, because I also haven't finished the book yet. In this movie, Sean Connery once again gives an incredible performance. And a fun fact that I forgot to mention in my Dr. No review is that the writer of the books, Ian Fleming, first didn't think Sean Connery was right for the part at all. But after seeing the movie Dr. No, Ian Fleming was so blown away by Sean Connery's performance that he gave the James Bond character from the books a Scottish background. So that's very cool. And pretty much all the other actors in this movie are very good. Pedro Armendáriz as Karen Bay was very good, who sadly died shortly after filming this movie. And Robert Shaw as Red Grant was very good. He was a very menacing bad guy. And once again, the Bond girl is dubbed over, so I can't fully judge her performance. But once again, If I judge her by her looks, it is a very big positive. And actually, another big positive about the Bond girl of this movie is that she's very important to the story. Honey Rider from Dr. No is very iconic, but when you really think about it, she wasn't even relevant to the plot of that movie. In this movie, however, she is one of the plot points. So the story can't happen without her. And in this movie, we also have very iconic moments, like the bed scene, which became an audition scene for the following Bond actors. We get introduced to Blofeld, which was very cool. And that was all very classic Bond stuff, where we don't see Blofeld's face, but just stroking his white cat, which is now a staple in pop culture and is parodied a whole bunch of times. Another iconic moment is the train fight, which was very awesome. One of the best fight scenes of the entire series. Heck, one of the best fight scenes of all time. And all the stuff aboard of the Orient Express is just masterfully directed. You constantly feel the presence of Red Grant, while Bond himself doesn't know a thing yet. And that is what makes all that stuff so thrilling. And much like Dr. No, this isn't much of an action movie, but just a straight up spy thriller, which I really love. So, like I said, this movie improves on pretty much all fronts of Dr. No. And this also is one of my personal favorite Bond movies. And if it's your favorite, I definitely wouldn't disagree with you. I don't think you're wrong or anything. It's not my personal favorite, but definitely one of my personal favorites. My final score is a 9.5 overall and a 10 out of 10 on the entertainment scale. And this is a must watch, even if you're not a Bond fan. Comment down below what you thought of From Russia With Love. Did you hate it? Did you love it? Did you thought it was okay? I'm very curious. Comment down below. And be sure to like this video. And be sure to subscribe to my channel. And hopefully I will see you later.